From Dusk Till Dawn is still well remembered for its unique style, music, brutality and also humor. What was the decision behind it to transfer and reboot it as a TV series?
Well, I've always loved that film. Fans really love it, and it was one of some of Quentin's best characters. His script was the shortest of his scripts, and I thought I had a theory that you could probably expand it into something more. I always wanted to do more with it. I had added some elements that were in the film that people really liked, like the whole Aztec mythology and the Mayan temple and the snake dance or the Salma Hayek character. None of that was in the original script. And I always wanted to do more with it, and I've had that painting of that last pullback shot on my wall for, 18 years. And when I had the opportunity to do my first television series, I thought that was the most expandable. And even Quentin was really surprised how far we could take his script and turn it into this big, more massive script. We had to kind of reboot it, redo it to set it up for future seasons. So we couldn't just start where we left off, because most of the characters were dead in the movie. So we had to retell it in a new way. And that was the most fun, was filling in the blanks and taking it in unexpected directions. And I think it came out awesome. I really love it.
Interesting.
Personally, for me, From Dusk Till Dawn was my first R-rated movie at the age of 15. At that time, everyone had to see this movie. If not, you were not part of the group. Zane and DJ, do you remember your moment when you first watched From Dusk Till Dawn, and how was the impact on you?
Yeah, I remember. I was too young. Technically, when I saw it, and that movie was a lot of firsts for me. It was the first time I saw anything that Quentin had written, and obviously he's got such a specific style of dialogue and such larger than life characters, and I just remember getting sucked into this crazy story and this interesting heightened dialogue, and it was one of the first films of Roberts that I'd seen, and again, it's the same thing. You get sucked into this amazing world of heightened action, and everything's so larger than life and iconic, and the movie put me through puberty the first time I saw Salma Hayek come on the stage. I mean, it was an exciting movie. You get like four different types of film experiences in one, so it was a lot of firsts for me.
I think I actually saw it late, not in my 20s or anything, but probably like early teens too, and the first time that I saw a piece of it was on TV. And I was heading out the door or whatever, and I think I maybe watched one commercial break to one commercial break. And I was, it's the part where the geckos are trying to kidnap the family and take him across the border. I was like, oh, this is a cool gangster movie. I'm gonna look it up and watch it another day. So I missed the whole turn. Going back to watch it, I still didn't know that was gonna come. So I still got to have that first sort of surprise that the audience gets to have. I just remember being so shocked that you were allowed to do that you could almost trick the audience and tell them like, okay, we're gonna make this kind of a movie, and then halfway through, just turn it on its head and have it be something completely different.
It was big in Germany too. My band told me.
Huge.
My band that plays in the movie, they said, yeah, we had to go to Germany with us.
Yeah,
they
love
it.
We even watched it in the school. So we took a VHS cassette. Yeah.
We
had a TV in our classroom, and yeah, one of the guys had the VHS cassette, and we watched it, and one teacher came in, and we were lucky there was no gore in
wow.
The scene.
Very cool. I came out on tour with them once, and we played. We headlined a tour in Bonn, Germany for 150,000 people. We were the headline act because the people knew the music so well.
Wow.
And they had built a Dusk Till Dawn bar in Germany. And on the
women's
bathroom, it was Salma, and on the men's bathroom, it was a picture of me.
Oh,
I was like, wow, I love Germany.
In the original movie, we've seen stars like George Clooney, Quentin Tarantino, Harvey Keitel, Juliette Lewis, and many more. How hard was it for you to step in their shoes as an actor, and how hard was it for you as a producer to continue this legacy?
What was cool was that, George Clooney wasn't a star in that movie. Salma Hayek wasn't a star in that movie. The star, if you look at the credits, Harvey Keitel's name's first. He was the star. That movie made stars out of people because, again, they're Quentin Tarantino characters, the dialogue, the the characterization that you can expand, and it's just a cool movie that it was fun to get to go do that again, go find people who could become stars off this show and get to play these characters that are so iconic, because it's the characters that are iconic. They made the actors iconic, but it was that characters came first. So to go and find the right guys, this was it.
You did, yeah.
I found them and was so glad that they were like their only choices. It was really tough. If they didn't do it, I would have been screwed. But it was fun to go look, because there's never a lot of choices. The choice is always very evident. It's like right there in front of you, and you're like, there's no question. So it was nerve-wracking at first, just the idea of trying to find them. Then as soon as we did the look, they're like the first guys that showed up.
And when you were
sorry to cut you off, but that's all the time we have.
Oh. Sorry.
Yes. Dodge that question.